Peace, Universal Family. We're back with another amazing video. It's your boy Clocksyn. Today, we're doing a film workshop, y'all. So I'm going to this place. I'm trying to find it right now. But we're going to be doing a workshop about how to shoot some movies and all the, you know, super cool details. So I'm going to give y'all some good footage of how that's going to go. Yeah, I'm going to see. I'm almost there. I think I'm like 2 minutes away. We might learn the secrets of how these people be making these movies, y'all. The super good shots, the film, types of cameras. Like, I'm always trying to elevate every aspect of my life. And so since I've been recording a lot more, I want to learn how to record better, you know what I'm saying? Eventually, I'm going to have my own music video, so I might as well learn how to shoot them good, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, film workshop. Let's get it. Ooh, y'all see this? In my life! Oh man, y'all see this? It's nice.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
This place looks amazing. Dang. Is this where the workshop is?
That's what I'm trying to find out right now.
Okay. Got you. Try to find the entrance. Phoenix Hall. It might be over there. Phoenix Hall.
Yeah, it may be Phoenix Hall.
Yeah. And the pictures, it look like over here.
No, that's like the arts and crafts.
Okay.
Yeah. They have several different rooms they're using, so that's why I don't know which one is which.
This is like a Hollywood set or something. It's crazy.
So you just come in with your camera, huh?
Hey, gotta learn, you know what I'm saying? Gotta be ready.
That's right.
Stay ready, team. Gotta get ready.
I know. I was thinking that was being called. I don't know why.
Mm-hmm. See what we got here. Phoenix Hall, y'all. About to learn the secret too. I like that. Yeah, this looks like a set. That's what this looks like. Yep. Yeah, check out those walls. Fire. Hot fire. Yeah, man.
How long have you been doing it for?
A good year. Yeah. Huh? Yeah, come on in. Whoa, y'all, check it out. Okay, I like it already. I like it already. Okay. Are they talking? Cool. Thank you. I'm a little early, y'all, as usual. But this the place. Huh. Oh, they got like college chairs and stuff in there. Yeah, we ready. We stay ready. We stay ready. Let's see. Oh, okay. Am I too early?
No, man. Come on in.
Okay,
what's
cool.
Your name, man?
Adam.
Tony, nice to meet you, man.
Likewise.
Hey, the king.
Yeah, nice shirt. Boondocks,
hey,
yeah.
Adam,
hey,
man.
Adam. Yeah, nice coat.
Similar with the coat.
Yeah, yeah, man, we got to. Hello.
Hey, how you doing?
Hello.
Hi.
Adam.
Hi.
Okay. Wow, y'all got like a college setup. You know, like this.
Thank you so much for helping out. I appreciate it.
Y'all see this place? It's like a Hollywood set.
Yeah, y'all can take a seat wherever or chill.
Okay. I like these chairs, y'all. I always wanted to see one of these. I don't want to get too far, but let me probably pop one of these. It's like question and answer. This one's nice. Ah, all right, y'all. Yeah, it's
Petey. You know, I don't really know how many people are going to be there, but you could stop by if you wanted to.
Yeah, I love parties.
Really? I just don't really ever see you, Beth.
You know what's a love hate thing? So, like, you know, right now, I really love them, though. Yeah.
Good shit, right, Rogi?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Hey, Rogi, quit in the room. Just choose him.
Hey.
Don't fall on my
body. Gangsters, what's up, guys? I was just walking down the hall, and Nicola was right in front of me. She's wearing these tight white pants with this black G-string. You can see right through the pants, man. It was so sweet. It's 10:33. Here.
What?
I told her what time it was.
It's the coolest fucking story I've ever heard in my entire life. I can see it. Can I hear it again? Do you have time?
Yeah, Seth. I'm really gonna miss you at least because we meet up in Dartmouth.
Yeah, well, when you guys are in Dartmouth, I'll be over at State, but the girls are half as smart and thus twice as likely to fellate me.
What are you guys doing tonight, asshole?
We got nothing. Nothing tonight.
No, well, if nothing comes up, we can get shit-faced again, eh? I mean, you always call me a pussy and whatnot, but today you're wrong. At lunch, I'm going to the same place Mike Snyder went to pick up my brand new fake ID.
But I failed forward. I kept failing forward. You know, I started growing and finding professionals just around who believed in the passion that I was doing. After that, I started submitting to film festivals randomly, didn't know anybody. And was fortunate enough to get into some of the top festivals around the world and win some of the best awards around. And then also get admitted to the NBC program, the Warner Brothers program, Film Independent program. All these different accomplishments on my resume just happened because I picked up a camera and started trying some shit. So I say all that to say that everyone here is equal. Everyone here is beginners and amateurs. I myself am still an amateur. There's so much that has to do with media and film that I have not learned yet. So this is a safe space for learning, right? And it's only a matter of time before everybody starts to discover their own voice by just picking up a camera and trying some shit and discussing it and being inspired, right? So that's my background. And
we'll switch it over to Tony real quick. Yeah, hey, how you guys doing? My name is Tony Chenault. So I have a similar background. Grew up in Philadelphia, didn't go to typical film school. Kind of learned like DIY, do it yourself. Created a web series called Oh, and you can check it out on YouTube. Kind of went viral, over 3 million views in one season. And then from there, the film bug just grew for me. So I've been in this industry since 2014. I've been blessed and fortunate to shoot commercials with Michael B. Jordan, Lil Wayne, Pusha T, with, you know, those different type of celebrities with just some of the commercials I did. And the biggest thing, you know, with this program, we just want you guys to come here and have an open mind, be open to new ideas, be open to collaboration, and be open to finding out what is your voice, right? Everybody's voice is different. We all have our unique experience in life that makes us different, but how do we fine-tune it and be crafted the way where it works for you? And this program will be fun. We're gonna be doing a lot of field trips, things like that, in different studios, so you guys get hands-on experience and learn from other industry professionals other than ourselves. And like, oh, we just ask for you guys, just show up on time and just come ready to learn.
So what does my film represent? Failure before you succeed. Create an outlet to deal with the hardships of life. I've been through so much in my life. Tony has as well, right? Like, I didn't make it past the eighth grade, just to be completely transparent, you know. I didn't make it past the eighth grade. I grew up in an EBT household. I got kicked out of school, sent from household to household to household, and only now I'm starting to find out who I am through a therapeutic outlet, which is film. So everything that I was going through in life, hardships, I put it into the narrative. I put it into a script. I put it into a camera. And what happened was people started relating to that. They said, I can feel this film through the visuals, right? Like, everything that you're going through in life, you have to have some type of outlet, or you're just going to be walking around pent up with emotions. So film represents the hardships of life. You have to keep going, keep going, keep going to make something beautiful, right? So it's a perfect outlet. It's a perfect outlet for dealing with it.
So what will we learn? So after the end of this program, you guys will all be certified with Adobe Premiere. Raise your hands if you ever use Adobe Premiere. Okay, so you guys got some familiarity with it. You guys will learn how to direct. You know, directing, it's a job in itself. And we will teach you guys all the different nuances of directing. You guys know how to edit, screenwrite. Anybody ever wrote a screenplay in Final Draft or Celtics? Okay, we have a few people familiar with that. You guys learn about gas and how to properly light a set, Material design, which is something that's not talked about enough. Production design, how to properly include different set production items into your films to give it more life and more character. And then finally, sound mix. Sound is one of the most important things. And you guys are learning not only like with the boom, how to record there, and how to use lavalier microphones.
So the goals of the program. We really want you guys to find your own voice. Find the thing that makes you keep going and ticking, like, right? Like, you're going to create things. We're shooting every week. We're taking field trips everywhere. It's a very, very extensive hands-on film program that we're offering. But we really want you to find out who you are through this program. Discover your own voice. Anybody can shoot stuff out here. The thing that's going to make you special is how you shoot it. How you shoot it. So when we go out to shoot and you're captivated on maybe an angle or an object that you see or the sky or birds that's moving, explain it. What inspired that shot? Everything that we do in this class is going to be open for discussion, and it's a safe zone. I told you about my hardships in life because I want you to tell me about yours in return, if you're comfortable with it. If you're not comfortable with it, that's fine. The best art usually comes from those vulnerabilities, and that's how you find your voice, through those vulnerabilities. So at the end of the program, you're going to be equipped with the technical skills, right? Tony just mentioned all the skills that you're going to have that can transfer over to the workforce. But what's going to set you apart from everybody else in this film industry or media or content creating, whatever the case may be, is going to be your unique style and your voice. What makes you you? Because guarantee everybody has a story in here that's different and singular to them, right? So that's what you're going to be learning in the program. That's what we hope to teach and for you to get out of it. Now, also, I have to put this out. Filmmaking is very controversial at times. We're going to be watching international films. We're going to be studying religious films, political films, films that have vulgar language, all of these different things. So if it offends you, this probably shouldn't be the class for you, because we are going to go deep with some films, right? So we were just watching Superbad. How many people seen that before? Classic film. So we're going to do some scene demonstration. Just a little warm up before we get started with camera work. So we can put the
of your business partner. You know who we are? We're associates of your business partner, Marcellus Wallace. You do remember your business partner, don't you? Now let me take a wild guess here. You're Brett, right? Yeah, I thought so. You remember your business partner, Marcellus Wallace, don't you, Brett?
Yeah, I remember.
Good. Looks like me and Vincent caught you boys at breakfast. Sorry about that. Chad?
Hamburgers!
The cornerstone of any nutritious breakfast.
What kind of hamburgers?
John, cheeseburgers. No. We're together. McDonald's, Wendy's, Jack in the Box. Where?
Big Kahuna Burger.
Big Kahuna Burger? That's that Hawaiian burger joint. I hear they got some tasty burgers. I ain't never had one myself. How are they?
Good.
You mind if I try one of yours?
Your health is your biggest asset.
Quentin Tarantino, of course, like one of the best with dialogue and just holding tension and creating drama and action and comedy, blending everything together. So we're going to do a scene demonstration of this just to recreate a little bit of the blocking. So blocking is basically how your actors are behaving in the scene, where they're moving, where they're standing. The term is called blocking. So we need some volunteers. Can we get two volunteers?
One right here.
Good work. All right, my man. Let's get some chairs. All right, so the drummer's going to have to play Sam Jackson. He's like a cool guy, so we're going to have to play Sam.
Sure.
Right. So, Demario, let's have you over here. face first, let's introduce each other.
So, hey, Mark, or?
No. As your scene partner. So you say I'm Jamari. Yeah.
My hand is wet.
Okay, cool. So let's get to it. Right? So the guy was sitting in the chair, and then Samuel Jackson was giving this monologue, right? He's about to shoot the guy. Now it's just basic coverage. I mean, it's disguised with dialogue and action and comedy, so you don't really notice what's going on with the camera and the cuts and whatnot, but it's very basic. So Tony, can you get the camera? Mm-hmm. Tony would be the DP here. DP is director of photography, basically the cameraman. Right, so first things first we want to do to capture this is get an establishing shot. Establishing shot, massive shot. Alright, so now that we have two of our subjects in frame, this is basically the widest shot that we can get for our scene. Alright, so that's shot one, establishing shot. Then we would want to get a single shot right here. So basically, once we're here, we can get multiple shots out of this angle. So we can get the shot from here to be like a medium, or we can even punch in tighter with a close-up to get her facial expression. That's basically what they were doing. So if you see right now, Samuel Jackson is on a close-up, but they were on the same angle, right? So just by having the camera set up here, we can get two different angles from me.
Two different angles. Get a close-up and get a medium.
Close-up and medium. Right? So, she would go through her lines, she would deliver everything excellently, because she's an incredible actor, of course. Mm-hmm. And then, everything that we do here, we got to reverse it.
On the same call, same
to get Jamari's coverage. Right? And we can get the same type of looks. We can get a medium, and we can also punch it and get a close-up. So those are three basic setups to keep your scene moving. Now they would go through their dialogue and do their scene, but our job would be to get the coverage, which is basic coverage. So once we get this, that, and also some close-ups, we have a full scene. We have everything that we need to keep the scene fluid and to cut it together.
Can we go back a little bit and talk while we're shooting the scene line? Let's just talk a little bit about that. So anybody have a question why we shoot on the same line? Mm-hmm. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Or why we do that?
I do. Does it, when y'all do that, does it make the film better?
Well, when it cuts, so right, when it cuts, you got the cuts off the same axis. So if we can't shoot this way, her close up, and then shoot your close up this way, it don't cut well if we go close single to single. That makes sense? Because now the eye line is going to be off. Mm-hmm. So that's why we always shoot on the same 180 axis. Yes,
so they basically got to do that scene like 4 or 5 times, huh?
Oh, for sure.
Gotcha.
Yeah. Takes like 4 or 5 times. Okay. You have more options in the editing room to be able to pick from that.
So you shoot the whole scene from angle, whole scene from that angle, yep. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Now what is interesting is, and once you know those rules, you can break them. Because Tarantino does break that 180 line. He does break that.
This right here, he's going to break the shot.
Right. He does set up a camera right here. And sometimes you can use that to add some friction in your scene. But you have to know what you're doing to execute that. Yeah. Right? So once you got this basic coverage, that's fine. You make sure you get the basic stuff. But then also, usually as directors, we try to add what we call a specialty shot. That's where your voice comes in. That's where it's going to set you apart. And Tarantino decided to set it here and get that close-up on Samuel Jackson. Mm-hmm. Now, your specialty shot could be anything. You can set up the camera here. You can set up the camera here. You can even set up the camera here. Wherever you want to set it.
So when we set the camera here, right, we want him to look heroic. This way to shoot up, right? Mm-hmm. To make him look larger than life, right? Mm-hmm. So that's when you would use that particular shot, shoot upward.
question. Yes. Well, what you get if you shoot up?
Bird's eye view.
Bird's eye view, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, bird's eye view to make your subject look a little smaller, yeah. Right? Like, but like, first, make sure you nail the basic of coverage before you try to experiment. You know, like once you master this stuff, then you can start to open up your range a bit, right? So this is just basic scene analysis. Anybody have any questions about what we just reviewed or what we've seen?
What are you talking about, the basics again?
Yeah.
Yeah, so go over again?
Yeah, so Tony's my camera.
Would it help if you're able to see it?
Come here, yeah.
No. Short hair?
Yeah, I'm good.
Does anybody want to see it?
Anybody want to see it? Like, it's how I look in frame?
Yes, I do.
You can come down if you want.
We'll let you see how it looks. Tony's the cameraman and I'm the director. My job is to communicate with him, like, hey, okay, let's get the master shot. Right here, I want it right here. Then the actors will go through their scenes, right?
And I will strike down the punch with great vengeance.
Good actor. Yeah. So this is the establishing shot. We want to get this first because this is our master. We can see both subjects. Okay, yeah. All right, cool. So we got the master. They did their scene. Mm-hmm. And let me get Jamari's coverage.
On an angle or a tree
on? On an angle.
Got you.
All right, let's get it.
And straight on with your left hand here.
Straight on, yeah. You off your shoulder, but on the angle may be a little more interesting, right?
Mm-hmm. Right, so the cameraman is going to know what I'm talking about when I say get Jamari's coverage. We're getting his coverage.
Make sense?
I just don't mean like that hold.
His single. So we gotta get his single. So the master, single, then single for coverage. See how each shot gotta cut, they gotta have their own coverage. And we go through the whole scene from the top, each angle.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, so because this is coverage, like on focus on one. So right. Things he said that's important, we will cut to the scene. Right? We won't have that master scene because we want more to fill.
And let's get a, let's stay here and get a close up. So we're on the same angle.
But this is the farthest you go, it's not the 85.
So that's fine. Yeah. So we got Jamari's coverage from waist up, and now we're getting closer. About here for a close up, right?
And then I can mess with the focus too, right? So look, that's when mess with the focus. So I can kind of like rack focus and then dig even more sharp. Song 87 is great.
And let's reverse.
Yep. The same.
Yes. Yep. Now remember, whatever we do to this side, we have to do to this side. Because they're having a conversation, so it has to blend well. Everybody understand that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Look at him.
Mm-hmm. So we're getting the same coverage, waist, and then also a close-up. Yep.
Do people usually do that with like two cameras, or just do two shots, like two different?
It depends. Tarantino's using one camera, right? But if you want to do something like TV, you have two, three cameras set up.
Sometimes four.
Yeah, because they gotta move fast.
Yeah, they got longer days than the film.
You gotta move fast. But if it's a film, it's a movie, if it's somebody like Quentin Tarantino or Spike Lee who has a distinctive voice, they need more time to craft out their scene. So they'll be on one camera.
Can I show myself on the cameras?
Oh, they're asking to see the over-the-shoulder shot.
Over-the-shoulder shot.
No. The DP would make sure of like,
okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you see how we see him moving, like drift, like you see him in the frame?
Yeah.
You can feel him in the frame, right? You move over a little bit, so you shoot that over the shoulder.
that's why it's very important to make sure you're constantly rehearsing with your actors, because you have to get so much coverage.
Wow.
I like that take. So I would tell my assistant, hey, take two was really, really good. She would note that, or he would note that. And so that way, when I get to the edit, I don't have to look through thousands of takes. I can go to the ones that I really picked out on set. But if I have the time, then I can, you know, just look through everything if I want to be a perfectionist.
I know.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So that's the basic coverage of the scene analysis. That's what Quentin Tarantino did there. And he just built on that. He built on that foundation. Right? And so you guys are going to be learning this stuff in class. We're going to be shooting every week. Everybody's going to have a camera in their hands at all times. Everybody's going to be editing on top software, right? We're going to be doing screenwriting, bringing your stories to life. So all the things that you have in your head, all the things that you're dying to say, we're going to bring that to life and have a screening. And when we have a screening, you come up and you describe your film, you say why you did it, your inspiration, you know, all of the different things. Get comfortable describing what you're doing. We're all about intentionality, right? We're not just shooting stuff to just be random. You know, you can experiment and try it out, but know why you're pointing the camera at something, right? Like the specialty shot. Tony said, I wanted power in the frame. So we got in love with that. We want to make the subject bigger than life, right? Anybody have any questions?
What's the schedule planning? Because it said Tuesdays, Thursdays,
the class is just Tuesdays, Thursdays, Fridays.
Good job.
About 10 a.m. to 4 p.m.
I don't know you recorded it.
What are slates?
Excuse me?
What are slates?
So slates is essentially beneficial when you see a slate board. We're syncing the camera audio with the external audio. So when we go back to the editing room, we know which take is which.
Mm. Mm-hmm. I'll have to see that because I can't see that in my head.
Yeah, we have that in class.
Yeah.
Okay.
We're going to go step by step in class. It's 10 to 4 Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday. Keep in mind that you guys are getting paid to take this course, which is incredible. So we've put together a curriculum that is on par with a USC, that is on par with the NYU. Filmmaking isn't necessarily branded all the time to these communities, our communities. Yes.
Are the classes in person?
In person, yes.
And
yes.
December 3rd.
So all classes are in person. Film industry, you have to be very punctual. You have to be on time. You have to, you know, make everything that you possibly can because it's a collaborative art, right? So we're shooting things in groups. So if you're the designated cameraman for the day and you can't make it, well, now we can't shoot, right? It has to be that type of accountability that'll take you far in the industry, right? So we're asking people to have open availability on those days and make sure that you can get there on time. Yes?
What were those days?
Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday, 10 to 4. Mm-hmm. 10 to 4. Most film programs are going to be 2 to 3 hours, but we're shooting a lot. We're hands-on. We're shooting a lot. We're in the field. We're working with actors. You're going to have guest speakers from the industry come in and talk to you guys about different things. We're going to go on field trips. Tony has connections to Fox Sports Network, where we're actually going to go on the Fox sets and see how the professionals work. We're going to go to the movie theater, to the Academy Museum, all of these different things that are available here. This is really a once-in-a-lifetime type of program that's just now starting up, right? So it's very exciting, and we're looking forward to it. We're looking forward to it for sure. Anybody have any questions about, like, the program overall?
That sounds exciting, isn't it?
You got a question? Like, you got a question?
I'm thinking.
Okay.
Yeah, and it's a lot of fun, right? You're going to have a lot of fun.
How long is the program?
About 5 months and a half, so we start in December and wrap up mid-May.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun to collaborate and, you know, come up with creative ideas.
I guarantee you, everybody in here is thinking of stories that they have. Yeah. Everybody has stories that they want to get out. Right? The most powerful thing is your story. That's it. Right? Like, you see people in Hollywood, you think they're like super talented and gifted, they're doing something magical. No, they just have a story that they want to tell, and they know the structure. So we're going to teach you the structure to put your story, or any story. Yeah, the formula, right? Yeah, so we're going to watch one more scene and break it down. We probably need a few more volunteers, so just get ready.
Walmart Plus. It's Walmart Plus. Free shipping, no order minimum. For all the things you wanted, plus
we're gonna break down the shutters. We're going to break down the shutters for this scene.
Plus, no worries. Plus,
we're going to break down the coverage for this scene. It's a different type of pacing, different type of rhythm. Very popular scene. Everybody's probably seen it before. But similar basic fundamentals.
Quick shipping, because you can forget the forgetting ever happened. Walmart Plus. It's Walmart Plus.
That's the term, baby.
45
seconds! All right, don't think they spent that shit!
Don't listen to the game, and I hear you.
something they don't know about me.
Straightforward.
Yeah, but it's the first shot that you're getting of the scene, so people call it a master or establishing.
And then talk about how you get that shot, it's easier to punch in. You always start around. Why do you work the way into medium, then close ups? Okay, so what shot we get? Don't ask me.
Is the establishing the wide shot?
Let me see you throw the wide shot. That's way too much. And then I want you to hold it more straight. Yeah. See how I'm doing that? And then record. You can just verify it right here. Record for any songs. Yeah, y'all can go shopping for shopping. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Just make sure it's framed up. Mm-hmm. And then once you're ready, hit that red button.
And remember, when you're framing up your shots, the blocking is important because you're seeing what's in the frame. You don't want your actors moving all the way out here, out of frame. You don't want them moving out of there, out of frame. So you have to direct them and say, hey, this is your blocking. Well, we want you here. Maybe you could take a step back. Maybe you could take a step forward. But you have to stay within this range. Right?
What's our next shot, guys? Should I hit a solo?
Those
solos. So what's the terminology?
Coverage. Coverage. Is that what it was? Hmm? I forgot what the solo is called.
What was it?
Coverage.
No, it's not coverage. I'm going to show you.
Single. That's what it's called. No. So, how are we going to get it? Are we going to do over the shoulder?
So, that's singles.
That's your decision. And remember, we want to be like kind of like waist, chest, level up.
Singles.
No, a little higher. Because look, we don't know what shoulder you're going to match your shoulder. And then less hair room. So how we do less hair room? Talk them through how we do less hair room. Show them how I showed you. I want you guys to get in the habit of helping each other.
We're not always dependent on us.
So this shot is a single, right? Single. But it's also an over the shoulder.
So what does less headroom mean? Because you told me not to
So over the shoulder basically means you're gonna put the camera over the subject's shoulder. And then you would reverse it and do the same thing. So when it cuts, it's smooth.
Okay.
Yeah, once you got the frame right though. That's your frame you're going with? But less hair. Tilt it down a little bit. Right? A little bit up. Now that's right. Already now you hit record.
I think you should put the camera on her shoulder, like right there.
And that depends, whatever shot he wants. Because I would like a clean single. Clean single means that you don't see anything else in the frame. It's not over the shoulder, it's just on your subject, right? So that's a personal choice that you can have.
With depth of field?
There you go, yeah, exactly.
Sometimes, if that's the case, you would have this actor, actress standing on like an apple box, which we have one, but we don't have to do that for now, but just the, so the height difference is going to be significantly off.
So just line it up?
Yeah, just line it up, yeah. Yeah, you just got to be smart. This is a learning process, bro. Once you start playing around the cameras.
And this right here, they're doing handheld.
Let's hear them.
They're doing handheld. You could put this on a tripod to have it steady, but in 8 Mile, to get the franticness of the scene and the busyness and the chaos, you wanted like a little shaky.
Yeah, it felt like the camera was moving.
There you go, gorilla style film.
So let's figure out what is our special shot. It can't be the road shot we did earlier.
Even the camera was shaking when it was done.
I think so.
Mm-hmm.
Take it from the floor, larger than life.
You gotta take it up the tripod.
Oh, yeah.
Spike Lee.
Follow.
So what, the specialty shot that Yaz is doing, it's called a Dutch angle, right? A Dutch angle is something that's slightly tilted, so your subject is kind of larger than frame, but it also shows a distant configuration, right? It still adds that franticness, but larger than life as well. So it's a specialty angle. And it's something that you have to be very confident as a director to do, because it's such a weird angle. But if you pull it off right, like Spike Lee does it a lot, it really, really works.
So if you want to do a first shot, you can use an apple box. But in this situation,
there's a very, very interesting angle right here that's simple, but we can achieve it without taking up too much time. It's something that you call a 50-50 shot, right? So in 8 Mile, it's a lot of tension between the two rappers, right? So how do you show that? You want to get a little closer with the frame, still keeping both of the subjects in frame, right? So you would... You would come about right here. See that?
Yeah, I see.
Actors, can you give me one step towards each other? Right? So now look how much tension that is.
Yeah.
That's a 50-50 angle, right? And we can accomplish this angle even from our first setup, right? From the first setup, we can just punch in. When you punch in, you're just basically getting a closer shot to add more tension to it. So frame it up. Yeah. Now actors, can you do some hand movements like you're getting the bars off?
Correct.
Yeah. Now you see how much tension that is in the frame? Thank you, actors. You see the difference, right? You're holding that tension. It's a good confirmation, like confrontational angle.
What about that scene where they went around them? They went around them.
Yeah. Once you get your basic coverage, those are all specialty shots.
Oh, I wanted like an intimate shot, like
which one?
We told her to go closer.
The 50-50 shot? Yeah. Is it an intimate angle? Yeah, it's an intimate angle. Because you're getting closer within the subjects. But the correct term is 50-50. Yeah.
50-50.
Right, so
I guess
that's a good way to keep
half
coverage
of one and half of the other.
The closer you get, the more intimate
they call
it a
single. Right.
Now remember, in 8 Mile, they wasn't just focused on the subjects, right? You also had a lot of the crowd.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Oh.
And those people were of the community. They're extras, but they're real people of the community. Right? So they just fill out the scene, they get energetic, and you would just have a cameraman or you, whoever's working the camera.
Reaction shots.
Reaction shots, there you go.
So it'd be wide, it'd be seniors. A mixture of all those things.
And one last shot I'll show you before, you know, we're not overloading. But one last shot, which was an interesting thing that they did, was a whip. Right?
And I was going to ask about that one. Like,
yes. Which shot?
Yeah, the one like where it went up to being like this.
Yeah, whip pan.
So it's a quick pan. It's just a quick pan, so it's a whip. Right? So literally like whip, that's it. Yeah? So you would go from here. You would frame up your subject, and it would be active. You'd battle rap for me a little bit, and then you would, right? Just a whip. Now, a pan, what you were talking about, would be a little bit slower. You can pan.
Yeah, because they did it, like, it kind of went on, and then it went real quick.
When you go quick, that's the whip, right? When you go slow, it's a pan. You're panning.
And you see a lot of whip pans in like more sort of commercial music videos. That's when that Kendrick technique.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. They do the whip a lot in that Kendrick video. You know, a lot. Mm-hmm. That's what it's good to know.
Anybody have any questions from anything I've just said?
Yeah. When you talk about styles, because I know what kind of style I want, but I don't know what to call it. What's that style in the Kendrick Lamar music video, Humble?
Humble?
Dave Myers directed? What is
that?
Yeah, Dave Myers.
What type of style that is?
Would that be handheld or it's just...
I haven't seen the music video in a while.
Let's watch it.
Okay. Yeah, Humble. Yep.
He had a lot of
it was crazy. The overhand, the low. I'm like, how do I do that? Man, yeah, it's crazy.
Oh,
we got into the video.
It's a beautiful camera, it's a 6K, it's high speed.
This is my baby, the Sony A7.
Favorite director. Yeah.
You never saw the Humble video?
Oh,
I
wasn't noticed that. Oh, that was amazing.
Oh, I know it's going to be cool.
Oh.
Oh.
Alright, so let's break down a few of the shots from Kendrick video. It's a music video, right? So you need a lot of action going on. You want some busyness in your frame. But then I noticed that they had this nice bird's eye angle, and it also zoomed out, right? So a bird eye is literally what the definition says. It's a bird's eye looking down, right? So I ain't gonna ask nobody to lay on the ground, but Kendrick was on the ground there. You would basically get over, and you could zoom out. That's how they accomplished that shot where he's throwing the money up, right? So if you just over here, I have so much flexibility. And of course, on set, we always use safety precautions. So my AD would probably be here just making sure that I'm secure. Or you would have a step stool or whatever you need to do for creativity.
Or a jib.
If you want to take a more expensive route. Yeah. We won't be working with jibs in the class, but that's basically a device that can accomplish all the shots that I'm doing now. But if you don't have the money for that, there's still ways to accomplish that type of look.
Yes.
Right? So all I have to do is make sure I have somebody I trust next to me. I have boxes or step ladder or anything I can get over. Put the camera there and zoom out slowly. And the thing about these, they have a retractable viewfinder. So I can see. And I don't have to be over there hunched over. I can literally just chill. Just chill right here and still seeing my subject in the frame. And just zoom out while Kendrick throws the money up. Right? Okay. That's specialty shots. That's creativity.
Okay.
That's what we want you guys to be thinking of. Right? We're gonna show you the basics to capture. You have to learn the fundamentals first before you can move on to this. But once you get those fundamentals, do whatever you want. Do whatever you want.
Especially in the medium of shooting music videos, there's no such thing as standard coverage. You create whatever that standard coverage is. So actually more room to actually be freer and more creative with the camera, if that makes sense.
Right. So let's work on, or not work on, but can anybody give me an idea? So Tony, let's have you sit here. So Tony's sitting here, and let's just say Tony's a rapper, right? He's just doing his bars. He's from Philly, so he really got bars.
Absolutely not.
Right, so after I get my basic stuff, can anybody give me some specialty shots that they would like?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Come up.
Do the specialty shot.
Do the specialty.
But it's not just me. It would have to involve all of us.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Like that.
What?
Yeah, bring everybody in.
Okay, come on. Let's see.
Okay, so it's like a bird out here. So I'll be your cameraman. You tell me what you want. So what is she telling Tony to do? What's the term? Blocky. So no matter if you're doing music videos, no matter if you're doing films, whatever production, the terminology is going to be the same. So you want to make sure that you understand the terminology and use it so you don't seem like an amateur when you actually go out to the workforce.
Mm-hmm. Can y'all hold hands and come together?
Not all of us look like it at the same time, but it's a domino effect. And then we
put our head back down as a domino effect.
Got it.
Yeah.
How close do you want me? Do you want me just on him? Do you want a single on him? Or do you want a wide?
I want a wide.
Everybody's in frame. Structure this is we would say sound rolling. You would get your sound guides and make sure that the sound is rolling.
Rolling.
Right? Somebody said rolling. Right?
Rolling.
Then you would say. Then I would say as a cameraman, camera's ready to let you know that camera's ready to say action. Okay. Camera's ready.
Action.
One,
two, three, four.
Oh, this looks great.
Right,
let's do that low one.
Which one?
You low and see everybody.
Pick somebody to be a cameraman. Who's gonna operate your camera? All right.
Yes.
And
you were coming. Make sure this okay. So you were AC assistant. Yeah. Camera.
Right. And who's the actors? How many actors you need?
Everybody.
He needs everybody for the shot.
So talk to her now. Okay. What do you think? So before she start rolling, just explain the shot to her before she start rolling.
So the camera's gonna be pointing up.
Oh, you got an apple
boxer
right here.
Make it easier. Just apple boxer. Basically, everybody's going to be framed from head to the waist. You get like head on it, so it's low as possible.
Okay.
Zoom in.
Is this how you're going to watch it?
No, so, yeah. You're going to basically move them like this.
Okay.
Perfect. So now if she's moving like that, you want to have you behind her, press her, to make sure she don't fall.
So, sorry.
Can you tell you
is this the blocking that you want for your actors?
Yeah, it's
okay.
They're like a choir, man.
All right.
Yes. Yeah.
Perfect.
And what's your name again? What do you want them to like? Is these
guys like a choir, man?
Okay. Okay.
Blocking. So describe the blocking to your actors.
Yeah, y'all just be in unison. Just, you know, as the camera's panning.
Yeah, perfect.
Do
you want it to be like every individual person, or
do
you want the next person to
see? Yeah, but you're going to be constantly paying. When she
starts, going to be. The program is going to shoot their own film, right? We're going to shoot our own short film and play it back for everybody to see. Right?
What?
So, we're going to have lights, we're going to have camera, we're going to have everything, we're going to have sound equipment. The cameras. Just a small taste of all the equipment that we're going to be utilizing. So it's a lot to learn, because everybody's going to have to learn sound, everybody's going to have to learn light, everybody's going to have experience with AC, production design, editing, and before we can do any of that, we have to write it, right? Right? So you have to write, do your shot list, block, all of these different things before we can even turn the camera on. So it's a very, very extenuous process, but it's a beautiful one. It's a collaborative one, right? And we can accomplish it together, right? So did you guys have fun?
Yeah.
First of all, how y'all doing?
We're great.
We did a lot of information.
I feel like we just finished a movie.
I feel
you got one shot.
I've seen a lot of naturals, honestly. Jazz, Adam, like, I'm sorry, what's your name again?
It's Gia.
Gia, like, you guys just have natural instincts. Now you just have to learn practicality. Mm-hmm. Once you learn practicality, your creativity is just going to take over. Mm-hmm. And we've all been through that process. We still learn practicality. You know,
always
we never stop learning. So, and the biggest thing, like you know, Mr. Logan said, it's a lot of work, but it's going to be fun work. It's going to be something you love to do. You know what I mean? So, you know, always ask to just come ready to work and have an open mind. Because mm-hmm. a lot of opportunities to come out of this program for all of us. Anybody have any questions before we wrap up?
Also, I'll leave you guys with this. Like, the director that we see today, Quentin Tarantino, did not go to film school.
What?
He said he doesn't need it. He said, you don't need film school to be successful in film. If you have a passion for it, Quentin Tarantino said, if you have a passion for this, if you have an interest for this, and you want to do it, then you can. You won't fail. You're going to make some bad stuff, right? We're going to start off. Everybody's very green. Everybody's just learning, and it's a safe space. And the first stuff that we do is not going to be incredible. But at the end of the program, you're going to see how much you've grown. To the point where you might be embarrassed looking at your first stuff. Like I am. I cannot look at my first stuff at all. I won't even show it to nobody.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I won't even. It was bad. The stuff that we did today, you guys are way better than me when I first started. I didn't know what I was doing. It was trash, right? So you guys are already above me when I started. So just imagine when you're done with the program. You know, it's there. And also you get paid for it. So why not dedicate yourself to it? You know, give yourself a shot and have fun. But yeah, that's all I have. And if you guys have any questions about the program, any questions about what we did today, or any thoughts, feel free to raise your hand and speak up.
Question. So from today, the next time we all meet is going to be on the December
3rd. 3rd, yeah, December 3rd.
Mm-hmm.
It's Tuesdays, Thursdays, Fridays. Did everybody fill out an application for the program?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Awesome. And everybody has their contact updated?
Mm-hmm.
So we'll be on the reach out to...
We actually have something for you all to scan because we want to get a count of all the people in the room if you all have been accepted to the program yet. So we want to understand that. So Megan has a QR code. I know people do QR codes and you scan them and you'd be like, I'm going to do it later. I really need you to do it now, especially if you haven't been accepted into the program yet. It helps us to understand where you are, who we talk to, knowing your familiar faces, and making sure we're able to get as many people into the program as possible, being that it starts on December 3rd. So she'll share the QR code. Please, please do it. Try to do it before you leave. I don't know how many slots we have left inside the class, but I just want to make sure we're able to like see all of you. So please do the QR code. But I appreciate the energy you all brought today, and I'm hoping that y'all will continue to bring that. We have some classes that we might be launching outside of this program that are also a part of media arts and film production. So we want to send you information on that soon. It's very important for us to know who you all are. Thank you so much. Any questions, comments, concerns? No? Yes. Yeah, very limited. We actually had a very overwhelming response to this program, which is great, but we don't have a lot of slots in the program. This is a pilot, so the county will launch two more of the programs after this one, but tell your friends to pick up.
Hey, y'all, we killed it. We killed it, y'all. Yo, just left the film class. I was like, I'm almost out of storage, so I got to make this quick, but... Ooh, I'm up on that piano before I go. Yeah, y'all. Good things coming soon. If we get accepted in this class, I might be a film director as well. Who knows? But thank y'all for watching. Love y'all. And the adventures continue. Pew. There we go.
That's crazy. It's good.
good though.
That's that real shit right there.
Yeah, that's how you know it's real.